Don't you just hate waiting for results after you submit your SAS programs? I sure do. In this video, I'm going to share 5 easy ways to make your code run faster. We'll compare the results from different techniques using both SAS datasets and Oracle tables as our source. We'll get a good idea of what runs fastest in most circumstances. So let's get to it. I'll be running my code in SAS Viya 2021.1. The techniques we show here will work in your compute server, whether you're running SAS 9.4 or other versions of Viya 2. You should get similar results. First, let's check the difference between using a keep statement and a keep equal dataset option on the dataset that we're reading. If you recall, the keep statement makes sure that we don't write out values that we don't need, but it doesn't prevent any of the variables from being read in. In very wide datasets, this can make a difference in the amount of time it takes to read. When we run this using both techniques on SAS datasets, we're going to see that the difference that it makes is very minimal, right? That the real time for the first one and the real time for the second one are almost the same, with the keep equal winning by a very narrow margin. If we use this on database data, though, the database doesn't live on the same machine as my SAS compute server, so there's going to be some network latency involved. Let's run both techniques against the same database table and see what happens. Now, if we look at the first one with keep ID, we can see that we selected everything from the database table. We read it all over, and it took almost 10 seconds of real time to execute. When we run in the data, keeping only the ID variable had to be passed over the network into SAS. And we see that cut the read time down to 0.1 seconds. That's a huge gain. So, minimal gains with SAS data sets, but still faster. Very, very much faster with databases. I think the keep equal on the set statement wins. So we'll make our first thumb rule. If a keep equal on the set statement and a keep statement in the data step will produce the same results, let's use the keep equal data set option. One of the next choices we'll have is how we subset our data. We could use a subsetting if or a where statement to subset our data by ID. Once again, we're going to start using that SAS data set. This one is a narrow data set with about 5 million records. So let's go ahead and see if we use a subsetting if versus a where statement, which one is faster. We can see that, interestingly enough, the first one, if ID equals 4, had to read in all 5 million observations. And that took about 0.33 seconds, pretty fast. But the where statement only read in one observation, and that took 0.25 seconds. That's a pretty good savings for just a small change in our code. Once again, let's take a look at the impact of if versus where when we're using database data. These same tables are replicated in my Oracle database. So I'll run the data step with a if ID equals 4 and a where ID equals 4 on the same table. And we'll see that using the subsetting if now takes 8 seconds, that's a very long time, compared to only 0.2 seconds if we subset the data in the database. Once again, significant gains on SAS datasets and really awesome gains in speed on database tables gives us our second thumb rule. If a subsetting if and where will yield the same result, let's use the where statement. Speaking of where statements, you can write a where statement a number of different ways. For example, we could say where scan of customer name 1 is Silvestro. Now that will give us all rows from this table in the database where the first word in the customer name is Silvestro. We could have written that differently. We could have written that using an ANSI standard thing rather than the scan function. Now, I love the scan function. Actually, I was so excited when I discovered the scan function in SAS. It was so easy to take words apart from phrases. But the scan function is not an ANSI standard thing, and most databases don't understand scan, particularly when we're using libname access. But the like operator is an ANSI standard thing. Not only does SAS understand it, but all databases do too, so it should be fairly easy to get the database to do the subsetting in this case. Let's go ahead and test those two using the SAS function versus the ANSI standard operator. And we see that we got the results pretty quickly. The where with a scan again read all of the rows in from the database, and this took about 0.43 seconds. But holy moly, when we used a where statement instead of a subsetting if, you can see that it was 0.03 seconds. Once again, an enormous amount of gain in speed for just a small difference in the way we write our code. Now, this will apply whether we're using a data step or whether we're using SQL. Here, I have the scan function in the where clause and the like expression in the where clause. And generally, SQL does a pretty good job when working with databases. So we still get the one record back that we had requested. But in this case, the first one with the scan took 0.1 seconds, 0.16 seconds. And the second run using the like operator took only 0.02 seconds. This is orders of magnitude difference in speed. And so I think we have a clear winner here that when we're writing our where expressions, we should keep those expressions as ANSI as possible. Now, of course, there's going to be times where the function that we need is only available in SAS, so let's put it in the where clause and not worry about it. But just realize that that might take a little longer to process than if we could write that in an ANSI standard way. So speaking of data step versus SQL, right, which one should I use? So let's do something simple like a summarization. Okay, so I'm going to take a data step that summarizes that narrow data set in SAS, and I'm going to use the data step to do the summarization. I'm going to use procsql to do the summarization. Let's go ahead and check to see which one of those does the better job. And I can see that using SAS datasets as input, the times are similar, but you can see there's a slight edge to the data step. In other words, the data step processed those 5 million rows in about 0.4 seconds, and the SQL procedure took just a smidge longer to do that result. I think when we're using SAS datasets as our input, it's probably a wash. But what if the source is a database? ProcSQL is a language that's much closer to the native language of the database itself, and so it should be able to do that summarization a little faster, I think, than a data step. In other words, we should be able to get the work done in the database itself. So let's take a look at what happens if we use a database table as input instead. Now, this is summarized on a pretty big chunk of data out there in a database, but you can look and see that the first one that did the summarization of data step, this time ran 7.5 seconds. But by doing the summarization in SQL itself, we managed to get all of the work done inside the database. And the database has an enormous amount of CPUs and RAM and disk space available to it, so it processed that way, way, way faster. Only a third of a second required to do that same processing in the database. So because we had a wash, pretty much a wash when we did SQL and data step using SAS datasets, and it made such a huge difference when we ran in the database, I think we can make another little thumb rule here, is that if a data step and SQL are going to produce the same result set, then we should use SQL. Now, this assumes, of course, that we're only producing one result from that processing that we're doing. If I'm using a data step to produce multiple data sets at once, this might change. And the reason it might change is because SQL can only produce one result set at a time. And so we're going to need to run that SQL query over and over and over again and read that big data set multiple times in order to get the same output. So let's test that. We're going to run a data step that breaks up a big table, narrow, into smaller tables, groups of 1 through 10. And we'll do the same process using SQL, but that requires an individual query for each one of those tables that we want out. Go ahead and run all of those. Now, once again, this is a very large table, and we're reading it over and over and over again in SQL. So this might take a little longer to run than we would like. And we have our answer. If we go back to the log and look at the data step, we can see that it created all those 10 groups, and the total time it took was about 4.6 seconds. If we go down to the proc SQL bottom line, we can see that it created all 10 groups, but it took 5.1 seconds. So this is longer than it took with a data step. And so from this, we can conclude a new thumb rule that if you need to make multiple result sets by reading from a single large table, then the most efficient way to do that would probably be a data step, right? Because SQL will require multiple passes on the big data. All right, and finally, our last thing to test, CPU-bound processes. Everything we've talked about so far assumed that the size of your data was the problem, that I/O was the problem, or network latency was the problem. But what if that's not the problem? What if what you're doing is really, really complicated? And so it takes a lot of CPU time. A CPU-bound process is going to be something we need to think about. Let's take a look at a scoring algorithm that we run against that narrow data set. And we're going to run this to see how long it takes to score that data. Now remember, this is a data step. So the scoring process runs single-threaded on 5 million records. And we wait, and we wait, and we have some coffee. Finally, we've got some results. Notice that the real time and the CPU time are very, very close to each other. This is a great indication that the process is CPU bound. Now, a CPU bound process is not going to benefit that much from any of the other techniques that we looked at. We need to run that thing multi-threaded so that it will go faster. Now, fortunately for me, I'm running in a SAS Viya environment. That means I have access to CAS. And CAS is a native, massively parallel processing environment, and I could load that SAS dataset right up into my CAS library. So that's what I'm going to do. In CAS, we have to preload the data first. And then I'm just going to process it with that same data step with a couple of very small mods, okay? The small mod here is instead of writing out to the work library, I'm writing out to that CAS library I have. And instead of reading the data from the SAS library, I'm reading it from the CAS lib that I have. And otherwise, I'm doing nothing different. So I'm going to go ahead, remember that ran 40 seconds last time. I'm going to go ahead and run this again in CAS. Whoa. Instead of 40 seconds, it took almost 6 seconds there. That's an enormous gain in processing speed. You'll notice that that's because my CAS server has 16 nodes and it processed some of the observations on each one of those nodes. So that went really, really fast. So I'm going to say that if you're doing something CPU bound and you have access to CAS, you should be running that in CAS. But Mark, you say, I'm not in a Viya environment, I'm running SAS 9.4, and I don't have access to a CAS server. But that's okay. Base SAS also includes a language called DS2. Now DS2 is a lot like a data step, but it's natively built from the ground up to allow multi-threading. In DS2, you create a thread that has the program you want to run for each data, includes reading in that SAS dataset, that big one that we had. Now, the thread is nothing but a stored program. I'm going to go ahead and create that thread for you. You can see that this runs really, really fast. It just stores the program out there. We haven't actually processed any data yet. Now that we have a thread program, we can declare a copy of that thread in our DS2 data program. I'm going to write right out here to the work library, just like I did with the base SAS data step. And I'll use a special set from statement to set from that thread program and use as many threads as I have CPUs available to me in my SAS system. I'm going to go ahead and run this. This is running straight up base SAS. No fancy CAS involved with this one. And I got to remember that the original data step took 40 seconds to run, right? This, in a DS2, I don't have 16 nodes on my compute server, but I did have 4. And that ran the whole thing in about 8.8 seconds. That beats the heck out of 40. And so there's a good deal, right? Even if you're running straight base SAS, it is possible to multi-thread a CPU bound process and dramatically improve the speed. So for this thumb rule, we're going to say if you have something that's CPU bound and you have access to CAS, you should run it there. If your process is CPU bound and you don't have access to CAS, consider rewriting that as a DS2 program in order to be able to multi-thread on the compute server. So let's review quickly the thumb rules that we had. The thumb rules were if keep equal and a keep statement give you the same results, use the keep equal on the set statement. If subsetting if and a where clause give you the same results, use the where, right? We talked about if you're doing SQL and a data step, particularly when you're using database data, you should use SQL instead of the data set. And that had a caveat: if you intend to produce multiple result sets from that one data step, then use the data step instead of SQL, because SQL will require multiple passes. And finally, we looked at CPU-bound processes, and we said, hey, if your process is CPU-bound and you have access to CAS in Viya, then go for it, run it in CAS. And if that didn't work for you, then you might want to try rewriting that in DS2, which is available to anyone with base SAS. All right, for more information, you can look at the links down here. There should be a link to the code that I used to produce this video. You can feel free to leave any questions in the comments. And for more sassy tips like this, subscribe to the SAS Users channel. Thanks for watching, and may the SAS be with you.